It's February 9th, I'm Yonah Hackhauser, and this is Geek It, your daily dose of tech news headlines. Today we're looking at the new Moto Gs, Apple getting a big fine, and more. Let's do it.
Geek It.
Motorola's Moto G line of smartphones have long held the crown of best budget phones. Now they've gotten better. The new Moto G Stylus and Moto G Power have bigger screens, faster processors, better cameras, and new features, all while staying under $299. They're essentially G8s in everything but name. They both have a 6.4-inch, 19x9 Full HD Plus display with 16-megapixel hole punch and headphone jack and a Snapdragon 655 chipset. The G Stylus is the first Motorola phone to come with a surprise stylus. Think of it as a budget version of the Galaxy Note 10, just $700 cheaper. Full disclosure, my phone for the past 4 years is a Motorola G.
Geek It.
A test done by CNET showed that Motorola's upcoming foldable Razr had its hinge break after just 27,000 folds in a durability test. According to most studies, Americans check their phones around 80 times a day, which means the Razr wouldn't even last a year by those estimates. Durability problems are to be expected in Gen 1 of this new technology. Samsung had to delay the launch of its Galaxy Fold after test units were found to crack within the first day of use. But Motorola stands by its Razr, saying the test that CNET did was faulty, and their own tests show that the Razr would last years. I guess time will tell.
Geek It.
Ever feel like your older iPhone was slowing down? Do you just think that's what old phones do? Well, you were wrong, and so was Apple. French regulators have hit Apple with a 25 million euro fine. That's more than $25 million for all you Americans. After it was found that Apple purposely slowed down older iPhones with a software update. Apple claimed they did it to stop unexpected shutdowns and the older batteries degraded over time. But it also led customers to need to buy newer iPhones because their old phones weren't cutting anymore. Shame on you, Apple. That wraps up today's edition of Geek It. Until tomorrow. Go check us out on Twitter at geek_it_news. See ya.